holidays are just around the corner, and given all the pent-up demand due to pandemic shutdowns last year, by all estimates, it's going to be a strong one. According to a recent Fiserv survey of consumers, 26% said they plan to spend more on holiday purchases this year. What's more, 64% are going to do their shopping in stores. That presents a big opportunity for small business owners. I'm Donna Fuscaldo. I'm a senior finance writer with business.com. Today, we're chatting with Tom Niedbalski. He's the VP of Gift Solutions at Fiserv, and he's here to discuss all the trends the payment company is seeing and how small business owners can capitalize now and into the new year. Hey, Tom, thanks so much for taking out the time today.
Oh, thanks for having me.
So as you know, there's a lot of pent-up demand out there, given all the pandemic shutdowns from last year. This year is supposed to be a really strong holiday. What does that mean to small businesses who are facing shortages of inventory, supply chain chaos? What should they be thinking? How do they prepare for this?
So with all that's going on in the world, the tried and true gift card remains a constant and a consistent performer for large and small businesses each holiday season. You know, we're expecting supply chain issues and stockout issues with, you know, the traditional goods that these merchants might be trying to sell. And for 10 plus years, gift cards have been a good choice for holiday gift card purchasers and for those who receive gifts. We expect the preference for gift cards to grow even more this holiday season with those supply chain issues. And really the number one reason is really convenience. Gift cards remain a convenient purchase for buyers that may not know exactly what they're shopping for the recipient. As I mentioned, there's gonna be stockout issues, back order issues, where consumers are going to need that alternative to have a quick backup. So really for merchants, you know, some of the tips for this holiday season is, you know, have your store well merchandised and well stocked to the best of your abilities. Have your gift cards really on display in a prominent space where, you know, the traffic patterns of your consumers are. Because you really don't want that customer to come in, look for that item that they intended to buy, and then walk out and go somewhere else and buy it. So having that gift card prominent as a backup purchase for those buyers is really, really a critical part of your holiday planning.
So for small business merchants, these tiny merchants, should they be selling others' gift cards or their own? And if they haven't thought about offering a gift card to their store, how do they offer it, you know, in a few weeks from now?
It really depends on the merchant, the size of the merchant, kind of what their consumer patterns are. I would say for small merchants, it's critical that they promote their own brand, have their own brand available both in store and online. You know, the pandemic is still, you know, prevalent out there, and some consumers may be hesitant to go to a busy, crowded shopping mall or store and are going to continue to shop online. We saw that transition really take place last year where people pivoted to e-commerce and to digital. Some consumers are going to maintain that adoption because they enjoyed the convenience. So, you know, I really think that, you know, it's key to have your own gift card promoted in store and online, as well as, you know, the rest of your goods and services as much as possible available to those consumers. The idea of selling other people's gift cards is really dependent on your business and your customer traffic. Those programs are primarily focused on high traffic host locations such as grocery stores, pharmacies, and things like that, where the consumers are in those stores weekly or multiple times a week. And having your card on those gift card malls definitely provides a convenience for the buyer.
Excellent. If you're a small business who's like, oh, wow, there's, you know, store shelves are empty, let me capitalize by having a gift card or a store card and don't have one, Is it easy to create? Is there technology or is there solutions that will help you create it?
Yeah, there's definitely solutions in a path of least resistance to kind of get a program up and going. I would say with it being November, it's a little too late at this point in time for most merchants to be able to get a program up and going that quickly. But it is something that they should always keep in mind. It's gift giving is year round. So while you might miss the peak of this holiday season, planning on an e-commerce or a gift card program in store now is going to set you up for success for the post holidays, which, you know, you've got Valentine's Day right after the Christmas holidays. Then you go into, you know, really what we call dads and grads and Mother's Day that happens, you know, post Easter. So, you know, there's a lot of spring holidays that you want to plan for and get your program up and ramped up before next holidays. But the process is relatively simple, especially for small merchants. There's automated tools that we use that we offer to our clients to really make that implementation process quick and easy and painless for them.
On one of the data points from the Fiserv survey earlier this year was that 64% of consumers plan to shop in stores. And that's a big reversal from the pandemic. What does that mean to merchants? Do they need to have different kind of like contactless payment terminals? What kind of equipment and how should they be ready for this influx?
You know, that's a great question. And I think everyone is, scrambling in some ways to prepare for this. As we talked about, some merchants are struggling with supply chains and filling up their stores. A lot of merchants are struggling with just resources and staffing, which is going to create, frustration and disappointment within the stores. So, it's really a challenge. I do think, to your point, people are excited to get out of their houses, get back to, let's call it a new norm of transacting. But for the merchants, they really just have to make sure that they're offering a safe and clean environment for the consumers to shop. An easy way and a convenient way for them to come in, get what they want and get out of the store as quickly as they want, because I know some stores are still limiting capacity within their stores. So there could be lines outside waiting to get in. And this is where merchandising becomes key. You don't want the customers to have to wander around and look for what they're needing. In the case of gift cards, which is where we really specialize, having them merchandised in multiple places within the store is important. And for sure, having those merchandised at the point of sale where the customers can walk in, go straight to the register, pick up that card, transact and leave is critical.
What about contactless payments? Is that going to be a big thing?
Yeah, we've definitely saw a huge uptick, early on in the pandemic and post, with merchants really trying to wrap their arms around a digital or contactless experience. A lot more have adopted mobile as that form of being able to not only purchase, but redeem and transact through the mobile device. Using, integration partners such as Apple Pay and Google Pay and so forth to help streamline that. With digital gift cards, they typically come with a barcode included within the digital delivery, which is going to allow for a scan of the phone and prevent the need for a merchant to have to touch the card and prevent the consumer from having to touch a physical terminal to transact. So I think contactless is definitely moving in the right direction. And, the pandemic has definitely assisted in that shift.
So the supply chain chaos has been making it hard to get a hold of inventory, supplies, raw materials, et cetera. If you're a merchant and you're putting up and running a gift card program now to be ready for later, what happens come, you know, the spring and there's still these supply shortages and now all these customers come into your store with your gift cards? How should you prepare for that?
Yeah, so great question. You know, we do see a large amount of redemptions right after the holidays, to your point, especially in, you know, that January, February timeframe, that first 60, 90 days, you're going to see high redemption. That is a trend that we've really conditioned. I think merchants have conditioned the consumers because what consumers have come to expect is deep discounts post-holidays, where instead of spending $50 on a sweater, I can give you a $50 gift card and there's a good chance you're going to get $100 worth of merchandise post-holiday due to, you know, just the change of seasons and the rotation of inventory in the stores. So, you know, again, you know, the supply chain issues are really an unknown. And I think stores will be even more barren after the holidays with the merchandise. But that's, again, where, you know, having e-commerce in play, having a solution in play so that customers can maybe purchase in store and receive it later. I know I've had that experience when I've gone to a department store. They were low on my size and the color of the slacks I wanted. And they were able to still take my payment, secure the sale for them. And within a few days, that package was at my doorstep. So, you know, having that kind of forethought and planning in place to accommodate, I think, is critical. I know that's a little tough for some of the smaller merchants that may not have as sophisticated as, you know, systems and programs, but it's something for them to start looking at and figuring out.
Excellent. So, okay. So as an expert in advising merchants, what are some top tips or must-haves that they should have in their stores or be prepared to handle the influx this holiday season?
Well, you know, I think we've touched on many of these. You know, one thing is to really have the resources, having your store well-staffed to take care of it. We've all experienced, you know, I don't want to call it poor service because it's not really the fault of the individual employees that actually showed up to work. But the merchants are having trouble resourcing and staffing their stores. So, you know, one ask is for the consumers to be kind and be, you know, aware of these challenges. But for the most part, you know, the merchants need to also be kind to their employees. You know, we see an uptick in gift cards being used for employee incentives to thank those employees that are coming in and doing the work and doing the job and working hard and working long hours. So I want to, you know, emphasize the human aspect of this, of the people that are on the front line doing their jobs. So definitely take care of your employees and make them feel appreciated so that they show up to work, ready to work, and ready to do the best they can with that influx of traffic. Beyond that, you know, again, keeping the stock shelved or the shelf stocked is going to continue to be a challenge for a lot of these merchants. So, you know, every day, hopefully they're going to be getting deliveries and it's going to be a balance of managing the traffic at the checkout counter that's trying to buy along with, you know, backstocking the shelves with the product that's walked out the store. So, you know, you're going to have enough staff to continue to keep those shelves full while also, you know, keeping the line short as customers are trying to check out and get out of the stores. And then as we talked about, you know, gift cards are the gift of choice. They have been for over 10 years. They continue to be a safe gift, a convenient gift for many consumers. And, you know, I would just say keep those convenient you know, well merchandised for your customers so that when those customers come up asking for help, trying to find that item, you know, some customers are already determined to buy a gift card. Some customers are not, and they're looking for that physical product that you might have to substitute the gift card for. So, you know, have your store not only well merchandised, but have your staff well trained. They have to prevent the unwanted walkout of a customer leaving without a product. Gift cards are a great way to guarantee that bounce back, as we talked about in early January and February, those winter months. You want to encourage that traffic to come back into your stores. A lot of merchants, and we highly recommend small or large merchants, to definitely offer promotions during the holidays. You can turn a gift card purchase into, you know, double the business, if you will, by turning the purchaser into a customer, not just a recipient of the gift card. So a lot of merchants are running promotions, usually a BOGO offer of a buy one, get one, might be buy $50, get $10 free. A lot of times that purchaser is going to keep that $10 and gift the $50 to the recipient. And what that does is it gives you opportunity to have a, you know, a touch point with two consumers instead of one. And drive double the traffic in.
That's a really great tip. And I think that'll be very helpful to merchants. So this year, it seems like gift cards are going to be in the lead. Any final advice for merchants as they navigate the holidays and going into the new year?
You know, really, I again, not to be redundant, I've kind of touched on a few of these, you know, sticking with the human nature of this, you know, be kind, be patient, you know, not only with our customers, but we got to be patient with our vendors and, you know, really the people on the front line, whether it's, you know, the delivery drivers, the trucking lines, everyone in the supply chain is challenged right now. So, you know, stay human and be kind to one another as we work our way through this. It is an exciting time. You know, I think everyone is feeling good about, you know, getting out and, you know, starting to experience, the new norm and having that face-to-face experience. And we don't want that experience to be bad. We want it to be a positive for everyone. So, just having your stores clean, having your store staffed, having your store stocked, is really a key to, making this an enjoyable holiday for everyone.
Great. Well, this was awesome. It was so much great tips for small businesses. So I want to thank you so much for taking out the time today.
No worries. Thank you for having me.